Hey, it's Keith from Outlaw Speed Shop, and I want to thank you for tuning in. This week, I'm tackling another 1962 Chevy pickup. This time, I'm going to go a little bit crazy with it. As usual, if you like what you see, make sure you subscribe and tap the bell to get notified of all video releases. All right, as I said, thanks for tuning in. This week, I am tackling another 62. But I'm going to do it a little different. I got two vehicles here, a Bone Shaker and the 62 Chevy pickup. I'm going to be swapping some parts around. I want the motor from the Bone Shaker, and I plan on cutting off pretty much the front end of the pickup truck and extending it out. This is kind of an in-depth project for me. I'm going to be using a lot of styrene. And after doing the van video that I just got done, doing two big projects in a row is daunting, to say the least. But in the end, it worked out pretty well. So I start by disassembling both the Bone Shaker and the 62 Chevy. And it works out pretty good, I think, because on the Bone Shaker, these are the black wall wheels. And I have a lot of old vans kicking around, and the wheels are almost identical. So I can actually almost restore them almost to original, at least appearance-wise. So I'm going to be taking the grill off the 62 and pretty much cutting. There isn't a piece between these two vehicles that I didn't cut up. the windshield, actually, I think is the only thing I didn't cut. And I get this Ground Pounders Challenger I'd picked up a few months ago. And I ended up robbing this from parts, too. I ended up taking the wheels off of this because they were the size that I wanted. They were the color and the style I wanted. It worked out perfect. At this point, I'm kind of screwing around. The base is almost identical, so it would have worked out pretty good if that's the route I decided to go, but it wasn't. So I'm going to end up cutting off the front clip of the truck pretty much at the firewall, or where the firewall would be, and then I'm mocking it up. So there it is with the Bone Shaker engine, the Ground Pounder wheels, some styrene, the body. The Bone Shaker interior is all one piece. I want the gas tank off the back, and I want the motor as well. At this point, I was a little undecided what I was doing for an interior, so I split this into a few different pieces, and I cut the interior out as well. I don't end up using it, but I put it in my pile of stuff that I'll probably use at some point down the road, or at least I'd keep telling myself that because I'm a hoarder. Anyway, so I'm going to cut the back of the firewall off, or the front, depends which way you're holding it, just to get the engine pretty much by itself. I'm not using the skull. I'm doing something a little bit different on the front. Once that's done, I need to fit the firewall, so I'm going to sand it all down, grind it, make sure both sides are as symmetrical as I possibly can make them. I was a little off on my cut on one side, so I'm just grinding it down a little smoother. And just a simple grinding disc works perfect. So now comes the fabrication aspect of it, and this is a lot, and I'm sorry the video might run a few minutes. I try to keep them around 10, 11 minutes. I think this one's almost 15. So I'm going to make a styrene base. Right now I'm just making a piece that's going to fit inside where it needs to be for the interior. And once I get that fit, if you notice, I marked it so I know which side's the top. Now I need to make the frame rails. I'm kind of doodling, just kind of get a rough idea what it is I might do, or I'm thinking about doing. The frame rails will be sticking out both the front and the back, but I need something to adhere it to, so having a solid base is pretty much what I'm after right here. So I'm boxing it in on the bottom, so I have a flat surface on the top for the interior to sit. And I'm going to end up gluing all that together with, I do a couple different things. I'm using glue. I'm using the adhesion crap. I don't even know what it's called, but I use that. Now I'm just getting some lengths for what I want for the front frame rails. It needs to be long enough to, I wanted it to go pretty much past the front tires, and it's going to sit underneath the chassis. So that way it's got some place to glue it to. And now I'm making some cross member pieces to keep it sturdy and keep it symmetrical, so you can kind of see there what I'm trying to do. And this is just a lot of tedious work. I'm doing this all on the fly. I didn't really, aside from a couple doodles, I really didn't sketch this out at all. I just, as I was doing it, I kind of did what looked good and what might be right. You know, it was a little trial and error. I did screw up a few pieces. Nothing major, though. So back to my interior base, I'm going to notch out the piece that I did put in. So that way I've got some secure areas to put the back of the frame rails on. And these frame rails are only, I did this in two pieces. I did pretty much from the back of the seats where the seats would sit for the interior to the nose. And then I did another section in the back, kind of did that separate. It was just easier. I mean, I probably could have done it, but they're two different heights to keep the rake and to keep it as low as I did try to keep it. So then it's some styrene tubing, which is, I believe, 1/16. Might be slightly bigger because I think these wheels are, the axles are a bit bigger. So once I get that, I'm going to fit those on there. I had to put it on top of the frame rails to get the height, the ride height I was looking for in the front. So now it's just a matter of making a firewall. Pretty much put it on there, trace it out. Little filing, little sanding, nothing major. But I'm channeling the body over the chassis. So what I'm doing right now is I'm notching the firewall out. So that way when I put the body on, it can sit really low. And without doing this, it would have just been almost a quarter inch too high. So back in the 50s and 60s, even custom cars today, one way of cheating to get a car lower is to channel the body instead of the floor pan actually sitting on top of the frame rails. You're channeling the body down lower, so that way you can pretty much be scraping the ground, which is what I was going after here, with just enough clearance to get the wheels to move. So the back, if the back post on these trucks, I ground off the post, but I left the tab, and then I put a cross member across the back parallel with the tailgate. And because the wheels are so fat, I'm pretty much just putting two pieces of styrene square stock side by each, and then attaching it between the base of the interior to that cross member piece underneath the back post. It worked out really well. You have to make a couple spaces only because of the height difference, but it worked out all right because of the way I have to put the rear axle anyways. So again, this is a lot of trial and error. You can see right now I'm just kind of fitting it. Wheels roll good. They're tucked in perfectly, and they're not obscenely sticking up past the bedside. I'm not a big fan of that, but they are maybe a 1/16 over. There was no way. I was trying to keep them even, but I couldn't. Just with the size of the wheels, I had to give it a little bit. So I had the best of both worlds there. And with the axle tube for the rear sitting on top of the frame rails, I had to build up the back a little bit, which again I used a couple pieces of square tubing, and then I'll cover that with a piece of flat stock just to smooth it out so it looks good, and it actually works out. It's even with that tab that's attached to the tailgate. So in the end, it actually worked out really well, even though I was winging it. If I had to do it again, I'd probably make the frame rails go all the way, and I would have probably thought it out a little bit more. But it all worked out good. It's sturdy. I was happy with the way that part of it turned out. So I decided I'm going to use the interior from the original pickup truck, which is fine. I had to really hack it up and do a lot of work with it. Because of the way the body is channeled over the frame, I had to pretty much almost cut a good quarter inch off the bottom. You'll see here in a minute, I'll show you. When it sits in there, it actually sits below the firewall. So I had to pretty much trim it down almost in half just to get it looking right when it's all together and sitting flush onto the actual base itself. So you can see right there. And it works out good. I mean, the thing rides awesome. So the gas tank from the bone shaker, I'm just going to make a little base for it, mount that in the back. I just thought it looked cool, and it's a truck, and it needs a gas tank anyways. The bone shaker one is, we probably could be a little bit wider, but overall it was almost perfect. There's an open end on the gas tank, just the way it sits on the bone shaker. You can't see it on this because I got it up against the firewall, so it looks really good. So speaking of the firewall, there's a few little bits, I'd say maybe a 30-second gap in a couple spots just because trying to get it to fit. So the Tamiya putty was a perfect fit. So back to the bone shaker engine. The bone shaker engine, when you cut it up, there is no bottom to it. So I have to make and build up, I believe I used two or three pieces just to get the simulation of a block to finish off the bottom and to get it sitting high enough within the frame rails that the top part sits just about flush with the top roof, which is what I was after. Citadel paints, painting the interior. I painted it like an off-white, which was that screaming skull. It's like an eggshell. And then I tried to keep everything aluminum. I didn't want any chrome on this at all. And the only real chrome piece is the front grille, which I glued on. And I'm detailing here with some yellow fog lights. I do the headlights, and I do the grill openings and stuff like that. I did clear coat it matte, so it did take the shine off. Because I didn't really, I don't know, I was looking for, I went all flat black with this. I'd show you the painting, but I rattle can flat black that there's nothing fancy here. I know I'm usually doing candies and fades and all kinds of crazy stuff, but after the last couple projects, I just wanted something, I guess you could say ratted out. And I end up clear coating with the matte. I'll show you here in a second. I use a couple different things. Excuse me. But the engine, same thing. I flat blacked the whole thing, and then I detailed what I wanted painted. Again, I was trying to keep a very subdued, I guess evil is the word I'm looking for. Just with the stance of the truck and everything, I just wanted something that just had that look to it. I did finally break down and use the bead wire for spark plug wires, and I gotta say it was a pain in the neck. Sorry, I actually tackled it. I drilled some holes in the side of the block, four on each side. So there is the flat black, soon to be matte cleared, and it gives it a nice satin finish, which is what I was after. Now it's just a matter of assembly, and I know this is a lot of work, but I think in the end it was worth it. I was real happy with it, and I'm glad I tackled it, and I learned quite a bit. So I popped the interior in, popped the windshield in, and I'm going to use the bottom of the firewall right there where the notches are. I'm going to put just a couple dabs of glue there in on the back tab, and then along the inside where the interior will sit, or the base of the interior will sit. And that's more than enough to secure this. This thing's not going down a racetrack or anything. So I really, because I ground off all my posts, so I have no other way to mount this. So it worked out really well. It's snug. I sanded everything down very, with almost like no tolerance in there. So it's, you can hear it snap when I put it together. So that was really good. But overall, this was a very fun project. I made a little radiator, and I made a radiator hose. I didn't show you all that because this video is running long as it is. But this is pretty much what it is. I'm getting ready to show you what I started with, which was two vehicles. This was definitely an undertaking, but in the end, I think you guys will be happy. This is what it looks like. I think it looks pretty badass. If you guys like what you see, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends, comment below, and I'll catch you on the next one.